Hi and welcome. Today I will show you how to make this female buckle part into a FIM mold. We'll start by adding the vent up here. We will get to work on that later, but let's skip that for now. So I've added a vent down here. Pretty big draft, but that's good. We want a big flow, so the bigger the better. Another vent on the opposite side. So let's move on with the so actually today we're gonna do a double mold. Both female and male buckle in the same part. Make sure that you have some space between these. If they're too close, this wall will just burst and it won't be good. But these 3 millimeters actually works fine. Now I'm adding a gate for this part as well. They will connect at some point. We begin by adding the vents for the male buckle here. So we want to vent there and some more vents here, here, and here. So I've begun with a small part here, not really big. It's only 0.6 in diameter, and that's no good if you want to do a vent that goes all the way through. So we'll add a big draft for that as well. But this will make it easier to trim off afterwards. So now we add this chunk up here to the gate, and another piece. So this will work like injected here, and you will fill up this, and then you will fill up the two parts here. We'll make sure that we don't have any bad material that goes into the mold. It will just stay in here instead. So adding some fillets to these gate parts here. Now we've added a vent here for this small part. So remember, when you design a mold, first of all, you gotta be able to clean it as well. Injection molding is done with a high pressure, so material will most likely just be shot through everything. But when cleaning, you usually only do a syringe or you let it soak, so you gotta make sure that you're able to clean the part. Because if you can clean the part entirely, then you most likely will also be able to actually injection mold the part afterwards. So it's just a lot of vents, and if it's cleaned, yeah, that's good. So we added some fillets up here as well. And now we added a vent here as well, as you see, important. Now for the mold around it. As you see here, let's subtract the part from the mold. Whoa. Let's see how it prints. I'm looking for things to turn up all of a sudden. I like this, but since it's supported both here and here, it's fine. What I don't want to see is anything showing up here all of a sudden, because that'll just go to the vat and that will basically destroy your entire print. Okay, so this overhang here is a bit big, but we're not going to use this surface for anything because it's just part of the gate, so that's fine. So a chamfer here to get it off the build plane more easy. Then we added a rim up here. That's for better closure when we injection mold it. So we have the fixed plate over here and the movable part here closes, and this will squeeze to the sprue. Okay. So a nice fillet for the looks. And then down here, as you see, we have a lot of vents that goes directly to the build plane, which is here. These will most likely clog with material because the resin doesn't have anywhere to go except for in there, and that's not here yet. So when exposed, especially in the beginning, it will overexpose, and then you will see these vents clogging up completely. So we need to add some tracks like this. Right, so now the resin is able to flow out, get away, and that's what we want to do. So remember that if you have vents that goes directly to the build plane, add some tracks, add some chamfers, something just to make them bigger, and letting the resin move away. So now we have a mold ready for injection molding. Thanks for watching.